That was one tired young champion. What a great effort by the Bengal.
A lot of energy, a lot of excitement, transitions, moves. Jacob has a very, very bright future. But so does Everson. He was up a weight class and took the champion all three rounds. But a great performance by him as well.
Well, now it's time for the V3 Fights female battle. This will be a catchweight 130-pound clash between Olivia the Finisher Fisher and Pauline Pita Macias. This is Fisher from Fayetteville, Georgia, and Martial Arts America, coached by Mark Beckwith. To have Mark Beckwith and Kevin Henry in her corner. 0-2, looking for her first win. The 23-year-old is a striker.
She's 3-0 in kickboxing. That's her forte. She's taken some fights against some good jiu-jitsu girls on our card in Tupelo. She fought Hannah Guy and took her to a decision. Really close fight of the night, award-winning fight. So she's a tough girl. She's going around training anywhere she can, any state that'll take her. She's exciting to have on this card.
Well, let's see if she can live up to her nickname, the Finisher, and finish Pauline Pita Macias. But it will be a big old battle here. The ladies always put on a good show, and we expect that to be the case again this evening. So now let's get ready to meet her adversary, Pauline Macias. Originally from Lancaster, California, and now fighting out of Nashville and Nashville MMA. 1-0, the 28-year-old who's a judo specialist, coached by Chris Beasley. She'll be cornered by Cruz Macias and Mr. Beasley, along with Gary Stretch.
Just to talk about this walkout, who does she look just like coming out here? None other than Ronda Rousey,
Rousey,
one of her training partners.
I think you're gonna go Connor.
Looks just like Ronda, walking out just like her, inspired by her, one of her training partners. This girl is tough, like you mentioned, just 1-0, but she's got a lot of history doing judo her whole life, a black belt, national team. I mean, she's all about it.
Yeah, that's a great point. Black belt in judo, Olympic Center judo team, USA national team, multiple time national and international medalist. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape. Again, Fisher from Georgia and Macias originally from California, now fighting out of Nashville, Tennessee. They weighed in officially yesterday, Macias at 130, Fisher at 133. Again, Macias 5 years older than Fisher, but you can look at that as maybe a little more experience. Fisher's still looking for win number one.
Definitely a great matchup. Pauline had a lot of people come in from California. They're really excited about her. She's based out of Nashville now. Trains at the same training center that UFC fighter Luke Sanders trains at.
Swig of water.
There you see her dad.
Yep. That is Cruz Macias. And now she'll make her way up the steps and inside the V3 Fights cage as the ladies will take center stage here on V3Fights.com. There she is, Pauline Pita Macias, as we get this V3 Fights female battle in the catchweight of 130 pounds. Now let's get the introduction of the two with Michael Kelly.
V3 Legion, this bout is brought to you by Cloud9 and set for three-minute rounds in the 130-pound female catchweight division. And when the bell rings, the referee in charge of the action. The third man in the cage will be Clint Kolesinski. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. She wears the solid black trunks. At 5'2", she weighed in at 130 pounds, a striker, representing Martial Arts America, and fighting out of Fayetteville, Georgia, Olivia, the Finisher Fisher. And across the cage, her opponent fighting out of the orange corner. She wears the black trunks with the red and white trim at 5'4". She weighed in at 133 pounds, a judo fighter representing Nashville MMA and fighting out of Nashville, Tennessee, Pauline Pita Macias.
The referee for this battle is Clint Kolesinski. Again, scheduled for three-minute rounds. Catch weight 130 pounds in the female division here on V3 Fights. Round one, here we go. A How about that? No touching of the gloves. Fisher comes out with the high leg kick that's off the mark.
One of the problems we saw with Ronda Rousey was when she got in there with a good striker, she got beat. So this could be a similar situation if Macias isn't able to take it to where she wants to go. And also, once she scores a takedown, then what? We don't know about her jiu-jitsu yet.
Overhand right there by Fisher. Fisher the aggressor early. Oh, she ate a left. Macias just waited for it. Very patient. And she timed it nicely. Fisher continues to be the aggressor.
And you notice these ladies actually have to wear different gloves because their hands were too small for the small gloves that we have. So we had to get them some smaller gloves.
Good note to know.
But doesn't mean they don't have power behind those punches.
Now you saw that left hook right there from Fisher. Had some pop behind it. Now Macias on the attack.
Macias just a snap down. No, she wants this fight in a clinch. Judo is all about balance, pressure points. You know, you're pushing into someone thinking you're going to score, and all of a sudden your feet are over your head.
Now she jumps. Oh, she had full mount there for a second, and now she has it. Now she's trying to push Fisher's head down. Fisher trying to get out of that predicament there. Now she goes for the rear naked.
But
she saw the opening, but I don't know. No, it's not going to be in there.
Olivia's fighting it off.
Keep that chin down.
But you don't want to fight the elbow with the chin. You want to fight the hands. Pull your chin in and fight the hands. See, Macias relaxed, calm, but so is Olivia.
Exactly. That's the point I was going to make. She's very calm as well. But I liked how Macias jumped on that because she saw the opening.
Right. Now she's waiting. She's got another minute to be in this position, to wait for Olivia to make a mistake. She finally freed that left arm from behind her back. You know, if I'm Macias, I may let go of this choke and start throwing some punches.
You can certainly burn yourself out as well, but again, she's in total control with less than a minute to go in the round. Clint Kolesinski is overlooking the two fighters there, so he's on top of this.
Tried to tighten it up, couldn't get it done. She decides
go back to the drawing
to stop
board,
it.
Right? Now both back to their feet.
Now they're well, there's
that was quick.
Judo. But she got her own arm trapped.
Oh, she got hit a couple of times with the right. Oh, another right from Fisher. She connected three times. A little bit off balance with those leg kicks, though.
Not really sure what she was attempting to do in that roll. Looked like she's trying a real basic wrestling move, a wizard kick. Didn't have enough pressure on that wizard to finish it up.
Final seconds here in round number one. Fisher, another overhand right. And then Macias with a nice combination.
And
then a big
throw.
Takedown. How about that?
Wow.
That'll end the first round. And that's how you like to head around. Some dynamite.
Right, just like I was telling you. You think you're coming in, you're going to score something.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And your feet are over your head, and you're on your back in a big way. Exact move that Ronda Rousey used multiple times.
Now we're looking at some of the action. Again, this is where Macias was in control. Then there she goes for the rear naked.
You see Olivia's arm is trapped behind her back, which is really dangerous because you've got nothing to prevent you from getting struck on that side.
Of course, later in the round, you saw Fisher connect with about four overhand lefts, and then the patient Macias waited. The combination, a lot of strength behind that left-right combo, and then the big slam to end the first round.
Yeah. A lot of action, great fights, but we've come to expect nothing less from the ladies in V3.
I can't recall in all the years I've called fights a boring women's fight where they just went out there, you know, feeling out process, went to the ground, pretty much in hold. I mean, there's always action. It's always dynamite. This is certainly a great example of that. Finish, the finisher, Fisher and Pita Macias. Round number two. Here we go on V3 Fights. Light kick, punch combination.
So you can see Olivia sticking her left arm out there trying to gauge distance to try to get some kicks in and keep Pita away from her so she doesn't end up getting tossed over her head again.
Switched up there.
She's trying to set up a kick.
A little slow with those kicks. I think she telegraphs them, and I think Macias has a chance, an opportunity to catch one and take her down if she so elects to do so.
Well, she's not throwing hands as well to mix it up to confuse you what she's going for. She's really just gauging distance. Goes for a nice high kick, but really she had nothing behind it.
She needs to
follow through with the kick.
I mean, it was good height, good leverage, but there was nothing there. See, it's just waiting for that opening. Overhand right connects. And misses with the left, but backs away.
She pulled her kick back. Olivia did, you know. Not sure why you would pull it back. Execute it.
Well, that was a good lead kick there into the chest of Macias, and then she never followed it up, like you said. Yeah, that knee brace was coming loose in the first round, and now she pulls it off. She had braces on both knees in that first round. Now, neither knee.
That kind of tape job, it might last in a kickboxing fight, but in MMA, it's coming off. Macias really not being aggressive here. Maybe she is scared of the kicks. She's trying some sweeps. You see with that foot, she comes in
right.
And she's trying to sweep.
Right. While also trying to strike. It's
a lot more effective when your opponent's wearing a gi and you're doing judo, and you have the pressure on top to throw them off balance, followed by that sweep.
Fisher almost got tagged there after she faked the kick, pulled back, misses with the overhand right. Macias just sidestepped her.
Pauline not scared to throw those overhand rights. Looks like that's really her main punch, but she's a strong, big girl if she lands one of those solid.
So there she went to try to catch that leg kick because it is telegraphed. There's no question about it, but she was unable to do it. Approaching 30 to go in the second round. Not a lot of action here in the second round. So very, very unusual for the females, especially Macias. She's waiting to steal this round at the end.
Oh, nice kick, but Macias throws a straight left, right down the middle. Nice, another overhand right that connected.
Good leverage there on that Fisher kick, but again, off the mark. Final seconds.
That one actually had a little behind.
Yeah, a little bit. Also, she blocked it a little bit, too.
She actually followed through this time with it. You know, they teach you, kick through the bag, kick through the gloves, kick through the hands. Don't stop there.
Well, again, in that round, in my opinion, I don't think Macias did anything. And not like Fisher was real aggressive, but she was more aggressive. That's a tough one to score for the judges. Not a lot of action.
It really is. You look at Macias' corner. She looks a little frustrated. Things aren't working for her the way she wants. Is she mentally prepared to go into this third round? You see some kicks, and Olivia throws an overhand right. You see Macias coming in, and she tried that sweep there.
Right.
But again, without that gi on top to throw them off balance, it's extremely difficult. You know, they're really only landed one punch at a time, a kick, a punch. You know, I've got it a close fight. You know, second round could have gone either way. You know, so the third round can definitely decide the outcome of this fight.
And there is PETA. That's her nickname. Coached by Chris Beasley. She's cornered by Beasley and her pop, Cruz Macias, Gary Stretch, Mark Beckwith, and Kevin Henry in the corner of Olivia, the finisher, Fisher. So we are going to a third round in this catchweight 130-pound female battle, and here we go on V3 Fights. Fisher came out kicking, but they're going to touch gloves there for a second. Now Macias comes out, maybe a little more aggressive now.
Macias has to watch changing levels and putting her face closer to Olivia's feet. Lower her head is when a kick lands, more power Olivia Fisher's going to have.
Fisher's interesting. She switches off southpaw. She goes back to orthodox. So change her stance.
Yeah, she's got the boxing. She's got karate. So she's got multiple disciplines of striking.
What I'd like to see her, though, is put combinations together. As you alluded to earlier in the first round, you'll see the kick and that's it. She needs to follow that up. She got caught there. She got a lazy kick out there, and then Macias jumped on her.
You know, this is what she wants here. She wants to get in close. This is where she's going to score some points here, but Olivia's able to get back, but follows up with a kick to Olivia Fisher.
Now Fisher throwing some haymakers and a kick that was partially blocked by Macias. I like the aggressiveness, though, of Macias there because we did not see that in the second round.
Macias is taking back steps. She needs to get in close the distance. You know, like we pointed out, you might need a jab or a kick coming in, but we haven't seen anything too powerful from Olivia yet. And then she's going to get her into her game.
Well, you got to think this fight is up for grabs right here. Who wants to steal it? Who wants, not so much steal, but who wants to take it? Who wants to? Good leg kick there by Fisher. Then she gets caught. Let's see what the Seas tries to do here. Has the tour in a clinch.
Big throw here. Definitely win this round.
Right. The attempt by Fisher. Now Fisher's trying to get it out. See his kick right there on top of her. Now try a little ground.
She's in Olivia's guard. Olivia's got an open guard here.
Get all the way on. Get all the way on. Under a minute.
Bent. Being hit by. Looks like she's going to have to pass it. No. Not kick in the head on the ground. That would have been a disqualification, but she pulled it back in time.
Yeah, good sportsmanship too as they touch gloves. 40 seconds to go. Fisher came in with that kick in close quarters and was able to score on that one.
But when you think about what she just did, like we talked about the second round, is mental emotion. Why did she do something that she knows is illegal? You definitely don't train that.
Oh, big right there for Fisher. You're exactly right.
Mentally, what's going on with her?
Is it going through her head right now?
She's getting back in that clinch where she's definitely going to be better. She's taking Olivia down pretty much every time. Short time here.
Final seconds here of the fight. Again, you're right. Maybe a big slap here. Somebody can get it. May steal the round, steal the fight, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen. The end in a clinch, and we are going to the scorecards for the third time in three fights tonight.
Well, putting on a show. The fans are getting their money worth. This is a close fight. We look at the highlights here. And a nice kick by Paulina. Macias, Olivia tries to get a takedown, but Paulina is able to secure it and get into a full mount. In the guard, I'm sorry.
It was a strong first round for Macias. I thought Fisher did a better job, won the second, in my opinion. I have no idea who won the third. This is going to be close.
We're all going to be surprised.
So we await the judges' scorecards. Again, the judges, Mike Kane, Jimbo Sarant, and Joe Stallnaker. Fisher trying to get her first victory. Again, as Jason said, she'll fight anywhere, anytime. She's fought now twice for V3 fights. Meanwhile, Macias trying to stay undefeated. 28-year-old is 1-0, trying to make it 2-0. Coming up next, we've got the V3 Fights Amateur Flyweight Division Championship with Darius Kid Dynamite Foster putting his title on the line against Dylan Corcoran. That's coming up next. Still waiting the scorecards. They are in now. Let's go to Michael Kelly to get the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for both of these warriors. What a fight. After three rounds of action, we go to the judges' scorecard for the decision. The judges scoring this one for your winner by split decision. Paulina Peter Macias.
Well, no surprise either way. If they told me Fisher won by split decision or Macias by split decision, I would not have been surprised, but it is Paulina Peter Macias who gets the win and improves the 2-0. Now a few words with our very own Jason Liedervaughn.
Here we are with your winner, Pauline. You came into Memphis. You're 2-0 now. What was your game plan against a striker like that?
I mean, sometimes I feel like no end is the best plan when you're like more of like a reactive person and like all those years in judo, you know, you never know who you're gonna fight. You're fighting a million people a day. You make a game plan for every person. For me, it's just being focused. Obviously, don't chase her, striker. Put your hands up.
You came out with some high kicks yourself, some overhand rights. Looks like you stunned her a little bit. She was tagging you. You had that amazing throw in the first round. Kind of looked like Ronda Rousey out there. For those of you who don't know, she's a black belt in judo on the national team. One of the best judo female athletes in the country right now. You see her shorts, she's covered in sponsors because everybody wants to be associated with her. She's going to be the future of women's MMA. Who else do you want to thank?
I have to thank Rhonda. She's the one that got me into this. You know, we've been friends since we were kids, and, she really paved the way for women. So, I think everybody here in the crowd should have a big round, no matter what, for Ronda Rousey. Everybody get a big round of applause for Ronda Rousey.
There you go, your winner, Pauline Pita.
Real quick.
Hey, I have to thank everybody in Nashville MMA. You know, I just came from LA not too long ago. They made me, they've been so welcoming. Coach Chris and BT. And I thank my family for coming out here and Lynn for making all these sponsorships and everything happening. So, and everybody that ever worked with me in California, thank you. Appreciate it.
Yo, your winner, Pauline Pita Macias.
Once again, congratulations to Pauline Macias. Thanking all the folks back in California, thanking the folks in Nashville. Of course, she now fights out of Nashville at Nashville MMA, and thanking the one and only Ronda Rousey, who she says is a very good friend and got her into the sport of MMA. Coming up next, the B3 Fights Amateur Flyweight Division Championship.